Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. After a few weeks of cloudy nights, finally I got a clear evening and I was able to go outside and make the first astrophotography test using the Dwarf II smart telescope. I decided to take the car and go out to see how portable and easy it is to use the Dwarf II when you travel. I use Stellarium app to see where Andromeda Galaxy and Orion Nebula are located, and I selected one of the hills at the edge of the town for the first light with Dwarf II. Now let's see how fast was to start an astrophotography plan with Dwarf II telescope once I arrived at the location. I took out the carrying bag containing the Dwarf II telescope, tripod and accessories. As expected, it was very lightweight, having under 2 kilograms. This makes possible to take the Dwarf II telescope with you everywhere you go, and is an important aspect to consider when comparing with other telescope setups that are much harder to travel with. Having Portal for Sky, I decided not to use the USC filter since I wanted to image first the Andromeda Galaxy. Before starting the plan, it's good also to take dark calibration frames to remove the dark current and hot pixels and obtain a better image stack. Taking dark frames is very easy with the Dwarf II. You cover the telescope, select Astro Dark Mode on the phone app and just press OK. This process will be finished in about 10 minutes. We'll share more tips about taking dark frames in a follow-up video. Because I was close to my home, I took the dark frames in my backyard, and once I arrived at the location, I took the telescope out and attached it to the small mini tripod that you can see here. Then I decided to place it on the car roof and turn it on. I took my phone out, enabled Wi-Fi, opened the Android app and connected the Dwarf II. I turned the Dwarf II towards the region of the sky and made sure the lens is pointing high enough not to have obstacles. Before starting calibration, Dwarf Lab recommends using the autofocus on a distant object to be able to play solve and identify the stars when starting the calibration process. I have already done autofocus in daylight, so I press directly on calibration. Now Dwarf II will take 3 images of different regions of the sky to be able after to find deep sky objects using the Goto feature. This process took about 1 minute. I was surprised how fast it worked. After selecting Goto and found Messier 31 Andromeda Galaxy, I pressed OK. Dwarf II telescope pointed towards Andromeda Galaxy and I saw Andromeda in the corner of the screen. After a few seconds, Dwarf II did recenter it and I did have it in the center of the field of view. I tested first 15 and 10 seconds exposures, but some star trails were visible. So I decided to go for 6 seconds because I prefer not to have visible star trails. So let's try focus, auto. Let's see how autofocus will work on stars. Okay, it passed the focus point. The autofocus won't work all the time directly on stars, and we will go and do it manually. I think this is the best way. 300 images, binning 2x2, we do not have options yet for binning. Let's see again the settings, gain 106 seconds, okay. And let's see feature, 300 and start. The Wi-Fi range of the Dwarf II telescope is about 10 meters. Outside, it got really cold when I took the test, so I decided to go inside the car until the plan or the Andromeda Galaxy was finished. Now let's see the results with the Andromeda Galaxy. Looking at the finished stack of Andromeda Galaxy, the core was visible and some faint dust lanes could be recognized. Messier 110 was also visible in this image. It's important to mention that this test was made before an important firmware update that released an auto stretch for live stacking. That is a game changer regarding the results we can obtain with Dwarf II. Instead of having a darker image that we need to stretch manually, now we will be able to see a much brighter light stack that is also color balanced, and we will not have the red tint on the image. I also processed the live stack saved by Dwarf 2, but as I mentioned before, this was in beta testing before the firmware update was released. I believe that stacking the individual frames will give us a better result. To find the individual frames, I recommend to connect the Dwarf 2 telescope to a PC and enable MTP mode in the app. We can find the images in folders or by date. The images are currently saved in TIFF, but however, Dwarflife will soon make available also FITS files, making processing more easy. But for the moment, we still have to work with the TIFF files. If we want to stack directly the TIFFs in a stacking software like DeepSky Stacker, we will obtain a monochrome image. It seems DeepSky Stacker cannot debar monochrome TIFF files into color. I will share with you a fast way to convert TIFF into FITS by using a free software called Siril. It takes about 2 seconds to convert 300 TIFF files with Andromeda Galaxy into FITS. After, you can import the FITS into DeepSky Stacker and obtain a color image stack. You can find more information about this in a short video tutorial that I made. Once I finish stacking in DeepSky Stacker, I process the image using Photoshop, and I really liked the result. For a short plan of 24 minutes integration, I was able to get a nice color image with Andromeda Galaxy with visible details on spiral arms and without oversaturating the core. We can get better results, more details and less noise if we take more images and also longer exposures. And I'll show you how to do that soon. Looking closer at the image, we do not see lens aberrations like field curvature. We have beautiful round stars from one corner of the image to another. It's also very well corrected for chromatic aberrations. Seeing quality equipment on an affordable entry-level telescope is something you do not get with many products. I captured also the Orion Nebula from my backyard after I arrived home. I also decided to test the UHCS filter. Plate solving and Goto were fast, and soon I was able to see the Orion Nebula live on my smartphone. Moving on to the Orion Nebula image, I made a stack of 190 images of 5 seconds, a total of 60 minutes integration. No chromatic aberration visible, and also the stars were round up to the corners of the image. Unfortunately, I had also some clouds and haze that affected the quality of the image on this test. I also had to drop about half of the images because of the clouds. Looking at the processed image, a longer integration time is needed to improve the signal-to-noise ratio. Using exposures of 5 to 6 seconds, the results are similar with untracked astrophotography with a DSLR. However, if we will go longer exposure time, like 15 seconds, I think Dwarf 2 Smart Telescope will give you better results than a DSLR lens and a tripod. Conclusions: new update, future improvements, and recommendations. Now, an important question. Would I recommend the Dwarf 2 Smart Telescope to someone interested to start astrophotography and astronomy? The answer is yes. If you are looking to buy an affordable smart telescope that is very mobile and easy to use and travel with, like the Dwarf 2, to start astrophotography, deep sky, lunar or solar imaging, without spending thousands of dollars, I think Dwarf 2 is a good option to consider. And currently is the only smart telescope on the market at a price from $400 to $500, depending the accessories that you'll opt for. It is also cheaper than a good entry-level DSLR with a lens. Besides the astrophotography, the smart telescope has also other good features like super resolution panorama, 4K video recording with good sharpness, object tracking that is an amazing feature to use for birds, wildlife and sports. More nice features are also being developed, like live streaming function. Second question: will the Dwarf 2 still be useful in the future if you will decide to upgrade to an expensive astrophotography setup. I believe so, because a more expensive setup usually is much heavier and harder to travel with, and it can even fill the trunk of your car. On the other hand, the Dwarf II is the most lightweight and portable smart telescope in the world at this moment. You can still use it for live staking and astrophotography, where you travel or go camping. You can use also the other features for nature and wildlife photography. And it's just amazing how fast you can capture the moon or the sun using the Dwarf II smart telescope. And if you have any other questions, please leave them in the comments below. I think that Dwarf Lab released a good product that is already being improved with new updates. It's also great that Dwarf Lab listens to the astrophotography community and it is working to make the product better. After the first firmware update, we already have an auto stretch that makes a huge difference on live staking. Modified Goto that will first move to the vicinity of the target, then perform plate solving to move the target to the center. Also, they added Goto function for planets and moons. We will talk more about this update in another video. Goto and the plate solving was already improved in the first update and worked well. Plate solving was really fast and Goto was accurate on my test. I was surprised how fast Dwarf II found deep sky objects. I liked that the motors are also very silent. You cannot hear them at all. On the Goto window, we also have the possibility to enter manual coordinates. That is very nice. And the catalog of deep sky objects to choose from that can be improved by adding more objects to the list. I did have some problems on a cloudy night when plate solving failed because stars were obstructed by clouds, but this is perfectly normal. When testing on clear sky and no obstruction, Dwarf II plate solving and Goto worked well. Work very good. When testing the autofocus, I noticed that it did not work perfectly on focusing the stars, so I had to use manual focus. Having a good autofocus feature for stars is one of the important improvements that Dwarf Lab needs to make. Regarding the autofocus, we already have good news. Dwarf Lab announced that an automatic focusing in astronomical mode will be available soon. Also, FITS format will replace TIFF for astrophotography. I would suggest improving also the Astro Dark mode by adding more gain options like gain 40 and 60 for the dark frames. This will allow us to lower the gain to take images that have better dynamic range. And finally, let's talk about the tracking performance. I believe it's very important that Dwarf Lab will improve the tracking. So we'll be able to use 15 seconds exposures without having any star trace. This is important for astrophotography to obtain good looking stars in our images. In the first test, to obtain round stars, I had to select 5 or 6 seconds exposure time. From 6 to 10 seconds, we can notice small star tails, and over 10 seconds, they are more visible. Seeing that Dwarf Lab already made improvements after the first feedback in beta testing, I believe they will improve soon also the tracking of celestial objects. Until we will receive an update with better tracking performance, I will show you in the next video how to take 15 seconds exposures without having star trails by aligning the Dwarf II telescope to Polaris. Here are a few examples when the Dwarf II was polar aligned. We can see that the stars look much better at 15 seconds without having star trails, or with very small ones that will not be noticeable unless you zoom in. I hope you enjoyed the video and you find it useful, and do not miss the next one where I will test the Dwarf II smart telescope with longer exposures of 15 seconds. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new to the channel. Thanks for watching and clear sky.